people in this world, if you check the history, there's a history of failures.
Wow, come on.
And then finally they hit something because they did not give. Most of the successful business people in this country, they fail in a whole lot of things. But I had a commitment. I'm going to start preaching and receive, offering, receive the gift, but I want to leave this to you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. God's love for you and I was so great, friend. And my desire in life, like I told you last night, I don't expect you to be me. I care less about any material thing. I've been there, I've done that. I've had it, I've lost it, had it again. Lost it, get it again. Until you get to the place where you say, you know what, that stuff has no value.
Exactly.
I had to learn it actually, whatever state I'm in, get ready to be content. God help me to get honest this morning. Why is it then that you and I are so ungrateful? Like, listen, I want you to take time to think about this, because I'm going to be done here in a minute. Why is it that you and I are so ungrateful? Have we forgotten the price that we paid for us to have church? Then why is it that we feel like we're doing God a favor by coming to church? I'm not going to make it this Sunday, Apostle. You know how to hear that. If I wasn't changed, I would tell you, I don't care if you ever come back. But since I'm changed, I have reconciliation. I don't know what I'm preaching to. God sent me to talk to somebody. It's about time for you to make a choice. I'm telling somebody, you're going to keep walking around that mountain, being right, having everything figured out. No, that's just the way I am. I don't know about that opinion. See, that's the thing I say about church. Let me just talk to y'all 2 minutes. When I get with you preachers, we're always talking about how the people are walking away from the church, but they keep preaching the same message, something wrong. I keep doing the same thing and getting the same result. And hope for something different. That's insanity. What about if all of us in here make a decision? You know what? God did a great thing for me in Jesus. I'm going to offer in my life. Can I tell you something? In him, there's more joy than outside of it. And there's more peace. Can you just trust him this morning? Send him peace. I'm going to be a pastor this morning just for a minute. I thank God for every one of you. I love every one of you. I really do. But sometimes as pastors start like this, because I want you to hear this and I want you to try to get it out of whoever would hear it. Sometimes the blessings of the Lord become an issue between us and God. Then we begin to worship the creator, the creature more than the creator. Grab your neighbor's hand because I don't need to talk to you back. I can see something. I believe in what I see. The same apostle who says to you, if you sow a seed, it's going to happen. And for the most part, over the last few months, for most people, it's going to happen immediately. It has been. I'm saying to you today, don't let the creation replace the creator. When God blesses you with something, don't make that thing your God.
Amen.
You've been believing for a job, for 10 months, and God gave you a job. Now the job is your God. You'll make it to church when you can. So over here we can. We forget that we didn't have a job. And God made sure we understood what's happening because it was down to Steve.
Yeah.
And now that they call you to come to work, you cannot say to them, listen, I'm going to church Sunday.
Come on with it.
Y'all don't hear me.
Come on with it.